Today I'm going to explain an English poem in English, A Photograph by Shirley Toulson. Poet wrote this poem in memory of her dead mother. It seems it is a tribute to her. There are three stanzas in this poem, and these three stanzas depict three different faces. The first stanza refers to the childhood of the poet's mother, where a photograph shows poet's mother enjoying her holiday at a beach, and she's with two younger girl cousins. She was 12 years old at that time. And second stanza is after 20 to 30 years, mother remembered her past with nostalgia, and this second stanza refers to the poet's childhood when her mother was an adult. And the last stanza refers to the poet's adulthood when she is not with her mother. And this stanza describes the sadness of the poet. What is a photograph? All of us, we have a smartphone, we take selfie, we take photographs. But what it is? A photograph captures a moment in time and also the emotions felt at that time when it was taken. So whenever a person looks at a photo, it brings those memories back. Let's read the poem. A photograph. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so, all three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. A sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born, and the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. "See, Betty and Dolly," she would say, "and look how they dressed us for the beach." The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter, both wry with the labored ease of loss. Now she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. And of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. Its silence silences. Poet says, the cardboard shows me how it was. What is a cardboard? Cardboard is a pasteboard or a stiff paper on which this photograph was pasted. The photograph shows the poet how it was that day. The cardboard refers to the childhood photograph of her mother. And poetic device here, allusion. The cardboard's lack of durability hints at the lack of permanence of human life. Next, when the two girl cousins went peddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so. What is peddling? Peddling, you will see dictionary meaning. So, with regards to watercraft, it is an act of manual propelling a boat using a paddle. But here in the poem, walking bare feet on the beach would be appropriate. The big girl, who was the big girl? Big girl was the poet's mother. When the poet's mother, along with her two girl cousins, went paddling on the seashore, each of the cousins held one of her mother's hand. Poet's mother was about 12 years that time. She was eldest among them. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. So all three means poet's mother and her two cousins. Why did they smile? They smiled because they were posing for a photograph. All three stood still to smile with their hair strewn across their face. Maybe because of the wind at the beach. As their mother's uncle clicked the picture with a camera. Now, poetic device here, alliteration here, stood still to smile. S sound is repeated. Next, a sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born. So her mother's face was sweet and the photo was taken much before the poet was born. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Transient means temporary, lasting only for only a short time. In the photograph, the sea is still the same today or has changed very less. It seems to wash their feet, which by nature are transient, because human life is short-lived. Time fled past since then, and all those who are in the picture, in the photo, who all are there? Her mother, poet's mother, and her cousins. They all underwent changes. Her mother grew up to be an adult, and now she is no more. The sea has stood the onslaught of time. It is still the same. The sea has changed less, suggests the immortality of sea as compared to the mortal human beings. Poetic device in these lines, transferred epithet in washed their terribly transient feet. Okay, transferred epithet, and also alliteration in terribly transient, where repetition of T sound is there. So the dominant will be transferred epithet. In next lines, poet remembers how her mother was fond of this photograph, and this photograph reminds her of fond memories of the holiday, and she cherished them even when she was a grown-up. Poet writes, some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. See Betty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter, both wry with a labored ease of loss. Poet's mother looked at the photograph after about 20 or 30 years and laughed at it nostalgically. She pointed out her cousins, Betty and Dolly, and the odd way they were all dressed up for the beach. Here, mother remembered her past with nostalgia. The poet's mother laughed. Why did she laugh at the snapshot? This is an indication of the fun and joy she had experienced during the beach holiday, and she had fond memories of the particular incident or of the particular day. That's why she laughed. She felt happy. Her sea holiday was a thing of the past, and now for poet, her mother's laughter is a thing of the past. The sea holiday brought a sad smile. Right. Here, sad smile to the mother's face because she could not relive it, but she was glad that she had once enjoyed that day. But sad because she cannot relive it. And same way here, other side, poet, why she is sad? Thinking of her mother's laughter brought her a sad smile. Sad smile to her face. Both. What is the both here? Both, right? Both refers to the poet's mother, who is remembering her past that is sea holiday, and the other is poet remembering her mother's laughter. Both made a lot of efforts to overcome their sense of loss. So poet writes here, with the labored ease of loss. Both try with the labored ease. Labored ease. Why labored and ease? Labored means difficult. Ease means easy. As past cannot be brought back, both these past are remembered with the difficult and yet easy sense of loss. Poetic device. Oxymoron. in labored ease of loss. Labored means difficulty, ease means easy. And these two opposite words describing the same entity, that is loss. The loss of the holiday and the laughter was easy because these things have to be accepted as a part of life. They cannot be brought back or relived. So there will be always some difficulty in letting them go completely. So they will always be seen as loss. In last lines, poet says, now she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. Who is that girl here? Poet's mother. And of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. Its silence silences. So her mother died 12 years ago. That girl in the photograph seems like a different person altogether. So that refers to her mother. That girl refers to her mother. She died leaving behind memories. This circumstance refers to the loneliness and the sense of loss that the poet suffers in the absence of her mother. She has nothing to say about this situation because this is the part of a life. She is speechless. She has no words to express. Silence means the complete absence of sound. The silence of the photograph silences the poet. That means she feels the loss of her mother and finds no words to express it. Poetic device. Alliteration in silence silences, repetition of the sound S, and personification in its silence silences. So here it's referred to the circumstance or situation which is a non-living thing, and it has been given the human quality of silence. So this was the line-wise explanation of the poem, and it was presented by Alpana Verma. I hope you understood it very well. Thank you.